Hi, I'm Daniel from Journey of Braid, and today I am at an hacienda here in Cuernavaca, and I want to tell you more about this part of history that not many people are aware of. So basically, this place was built in the 1500s, 1600s. It's like one of these huge houses that you're going to see more of in a second, and it used to be a place where sugar was produced. So it was really important, and it was a place that gave lots of jobs, and at the same time, look how beautiful it is, produced many different resources apart from the sugar. But the problem is that during that time, there was obviously the Spaniards arrived and they settled across the country, and then they took people in that were working for them. But the way that they worked was it was very close to slavery. Because the only way they could buy things was through these stores that were called tiendas de raya, that had a very cruel system when it came to the value of things, and at the same time where debt was carried from generation to generation. So it wasn't the fairest system. Look at how beautiful it is. Ah! So that obviously led to huge inconformities, because this was mostly built by indigenous hands. And the Spaniards were just taking over until Emiliano Zapata appeared on the picture. Emiliano Zapata was a revolutionary. So we had Emiliano Zapata and Pancho Villa. Emiliano Zapata was in this area of the country, and the Pancho Villa was closer to the north, to the US, Sonora, all that area. So they started fighting, and they said enough. Enough of these restrictions, enough of making us feel less. We are the real owners of this land. And they basically went through all the haciendas, and actually all the roofs have been replaced because they just burned them down, and created a lot of chaos that started in 1910 and led to freedom. It allowed for people to be given land and to this very feudalist system to change. And it has been one of the things that has led to where we are today, after having had both monarchies and a dictatorship by a very famous president, or very well-known president, called Porfirio Diaz. So I hope you enjoy this bit of history. This is the Hacienda de San Gabriel de las Palmas. It's very close to Mexico City, about 2 hours away. And as you can see, nature is everywhere, and yet the old structure has so much history and is beautiful just to experience. I'm Dania from Journey of a Braid, and I hope you liked this video. If you did, let me know so I know what kind of videos to create for you.